Aladdin Creations.
Hello friends, welcome to another video of Aladdin Creations. My name is Kavindu. In this short video, I am going to discuss with you one of the most important and popular medical laboratory tests using these tests called PCR or polymerase chain reaction test. Actually, what is the PCR test? What is the principle behind this medical laboratory test? And how to identify and confirm patients using this PCR test? We'll discuss in this short video. You might have heard about the PCR test during this viral pandemic. PCR is the recommended laboratory test available to detect the viral infection as much as possible. The polymerase chain reaction or PCR is an amplification process which can be used to multiply DNA or RNA. Simply, the PCR used to produce millions of copies of target piece of DNA from very small sample. Actually, PCR itself is not a test, it is an amplification method. But the product of PCR can be utilized for the diagnosis. Any biological sample with RNA or DNA can be used for PCR. As an example, the virus has RNA in its genome. As we all know, the target site of the virus is the human respiratory tract. If we obtain those viral particles from mucus of infected individuals, it contains viral RNA. Therefore, the healthcare workers obtain throat and nasal swab as samples to check for viral RNA using PCR techniques. Like that, we can use any biological samples, including animal, microbial or plant material to perform PCR. Usually, the PCR can be performed for both RNA and DNA. In case of RNA, the reverse transcriptase PCR or RT-PCR is used. Here, the complementary DNA is prepared from target RNA template and the resulting fragment is used for the amplification. Let's see what are the necessities are to do PCR. Mainly, we need PCR machine, template DNA, this should be purified, isolated DNA fragment, primers, a known sequence which is used to identify the particular area of the target fragment to be amplified, deoxyribonucleotide triphosphate, tag polymerase, nuclease-free water and buffers. Mainly, there are three basic steps in PCR process: denaturation of template strand, annealing and extension. When we consider denaturation of template strand, first the double stranded DNA is broken and convert it into single strand. Usually this is done by heating the DNA up to 92 to 94 Celsius. Annealing. Here the primers sit on the complementary side of the strand for the initiation of DNA synthesis. Extension. The tag polymerase aids to incorporation of DNTPs bases to elongate the DNA strand and extension occurs. This is the thermocontrol cyclic process and after several cycles, it is gives rise to millions to billions of copies of viral DNA strand. So that is it. This is simply about PCR. I know, now you are in trouble. What is the fate of this amplified DNA? How can we diagnose a particular infection? Let's take microbial infection as an example. Now we have the PCR product obtained from the sample. But we can do this. We need to check our amplified DNA product is similar to microbial DNA or whether the microbial product matches or complementary with microbial genes. Gel electrophoresis and staining sequencing are some of common methods available to do this task. However, the ultimate use of PCR is to generate lot of copies of particular DNA fragment, which is large enough to study in detail through various techniques. Well, I hope you guys enjoy this video and gain some knowledge about this PCR or polymerase chain reaction test. So don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and hit bell icon to update with more medical laboratory science and medical related videos like this. Thank you.